Morning children, welcome to sociology class. We are studying about the classical thinkers and their theories. We have studied about Auguste Comte and his theory positivism. Today we shall study about Émile Durkheim, the second classical thinker, and his three theories: division of labor, solidarity, and the concepts of sacred and profane. Before we begin the theories of Émile Durkheim, let us have a look on the life sketch of this scholar. As a successor of Comte, Émile Durkheim's name is very popular in the world of sociology. It is said that if Comte has the credit of laying the foundation of sociology in France, then Durkheim is the one who strengthened the structure of this science. Durkheim completed a lot of Comte's unfinished work. Émile Durkheim was born on 15th March 1858 in France, in the home of a Jewish rabbi. Because of the family's religious background, religion and morality have a special place in his life. His elementary education was completed in Ecole, where he was influenced by many scholars. After his graduation from the Ecole, Durkheim started working for the doctoral degree. In 1885-86, he spent an academic year in Germany studying contemporary developments in social philosophy and collective psychology. In the Bordeaux University, he was impressed by Professor Espinosa. By 1886, Durkheim formulated the first draft of his major doctoral dissertation, which was to become the division of labor in society. He obtained his doctorate in 1893 and was appointed professor in the Paris University. Durkheim's 15 years at Bordeaux proved to be extremely fruitful, in addition to numerous reviews and articles. He published many books, but in December 1916 he fell sick and passed away on the 15th of November 1917 at the age of 57. So this is all about the life sketch of Émile Durkheim. Now let us begin the theory of division of labor given by him. The theory of division of labor is regarded as Durkheim's major contribution to the field of sociological thought. Comte's influence is evident in this book, Division of Labor in Society, 1893. The theme of the book is the relationship between individuals and society, or the collectivity. Society means collectivity. It is also a classical study of social solidarity, means unity. In this book, Durkheim has tried to determine the social consequences of division of labor in modern societies. Durkheim has used the concept of division of labor in three ways. First, technical division of labor, which describes the production process. Second is sexual division of labor, which describes the social division between men and women. And third is social division of labor, which describes the differentiation in the society as a whole. So he gave three ways of division of labor: technical division of labor, sexual division of labor, and social division of labor. Then he described two types of solidarity on the basis of division of labor. When he was studying the nature of societies, he found that there are two types of societies which are having two different solidarities. The first type of solidarity is mechanical solidarity, and the second solidarity is organic solidarity, means unitedness or unity or the mutual support of the members of society, which is known as solidarity. Durkheim classifies societies as differentiated and undifferentiated. Undifferentiated societies are mechanical societies, whereas the differentiated societies are organic societies. So he studied two types of societies. The first type of societies means where mechanical solidarity is found. It is a type of simple society or homogeneous society. And second society, where organic society is found, it is a type of heterogeneous society. So let us study mechanical solidarity. Mechanical societies are actually undeveloped, primitive, simple societies. In such societies, social solidarity comes from shared emotional feelings. People in society have collective consciousness, which is the body of beliefs and sentiments common to the average of members of the society. Collective consciousness is a sense of belonging to a community with others, and hence feeling of moral obligation to live up to its demands. In such a society, means in such a simple society, most people are like each other. So there is homogeneity. There is little or no specialization. Almost everyone is a farmer or a warrior. Accordingly, there is a strong collective consciousness. In such societies characterized by mechanical solidarity, the individual is an indistinguishable part of the collective whole. Individual differences are subordinated to the solidarity of the group. Means the people are fully devoted to the unity of the group. They are known by their group. Individuality is at its lowest point of development. The individual is integrated with the rest of the social whole mechanically or through drab uniformity and by force. So this mechanical solidarity we have seen is found in the simple primitive societies, which are homogeneous in nature. Then the second kind of solidarity is called organic solidarity. This organic solidarity characterizes modern society, which is heterogeneous in nature, and it is based on the heterogeneity of its members. Due to the increase of industrialization, there is division of labor in society. At the same time, urbanization, means establishment of cities, is increasing as rapidly because people come from far and near in search of jobs. And this leads to the growth of population in the cities or organic societies. In these societies, there is a specialization of functions. One person cannot perform all the duties or all the production work because here is specialization. So one person can specialize in one or at best two areas, but his needs are many for which he has to take the help of other people or agencies. Thus, there is interdependence among people. For example, a person produces a commodity and takes it to the market to sell it. Thus, people establish relationship with the producer. On the other hand, the producer has to fulfill his needs of food, clothing, shelter, education, entertainment, etc. So he depends on other agencies to fulfill his needs. So we have seen that here we find division of labor because these societies follow specialization. And everyone cannot be specialized in all the spheres of production work, but he has to depend on others to satisfy his needs. Thus, division of labor divides people on one hand and makes them dependent on each other on the other hand. So, again I am repeating, children, there are two types of solidarities, means two types of societies are there. Mechanical solidarity, which needs no specialization. The people are simple, they are homogeneous in nature and the task is not very specialized. So this kind of solidarity, mechanical solidarity, is found in the simple primitive societies. And second is organic solidarity, which is found in the modern societies, which are based on specialization. So we have seen that there is a close link between division of labor and the solidarity. In mechanical simple societies, there is less division of labor, and in organic modern society, there is more division of labor. Now, Durkheim has given one more concept, that is the concept of sacred and profane. In his studies of religion, especially the tribal religion, he gave two concepts which are observed in the primitive societies, that is sacred and profane. Durkheim defined religion as united system of belief and practices related to sacred things. The sacred things are those which are set apart and forbidden. What makes any object as sacred is not based on its basic properties or characteristics, but rather an attitude towards it. The sacred things are symbols, and their significance lies in what they symbolize and not what they are. Sacred things refers to the holy realm, which is viewed with reverence. The sacred things are set apart by a peculiar emotional attitude of respect and awe. The sacred things are considered to possess special powers, are reserved for special occasions, and a number of restrictions are attached with them. So this is all about the concept of sacred. Then the second concept is profane. The profane or the ordinary includes whatever is not viewed with these emotions and regarding which there are no such restrictions. So all the worldly things are counted in profane. Profane includes those ideas, persons, practices, and things that are regarded with an everyday attitude of commonness, utility and familiarity. So these are the two concepts which are followed very strictly in the tribal religion or the primitive religion. In sacred things the attitude is different. That is the attitude of reverence, respect and awe. And there is a different attitude towards profane. So I hope, children, you have studied the theories given by Emil Durkheim, the theory of division of labor, then the solidarity, social solidarity, and the concept of sacred and profane. Have a good day.